The rate of flow of charge in a conductor is called electric current. This is the electric current that lights the bulb. We know that charge is always present in the metallic wires. So why do we need to put batteries in the circuit for the bulb to glow? Why is it necessary to put the battery? In the process of the lighting of the bulb, another physical quantity works along with the electric current, which is called electric potential difference. What is this electric potential difference? Let us try to understand this with the help of this example. Have you ever poured water on horizontal leveled floors and on slopes? Does water flow the same way in both the cases? The answer is no. On the slopes, the water flows till it reaches the bottom, and on the horizontal floor, it will stop flowing after a while. In the case of slopes, no extra force is required, whereas despite applying force on the horizontal floor, water stops flowing as soon as the effect of that force tends to zero. So, what is the difference between these two circumstances? Yes, you get it right. Height. Due to the difference in height, gravity and water molecules force each other on the slopes, due to which the water flows till the lowest point possible. What will happen if in the place of a horizontal floor, a water pipe is taken? What do you think, that we get the water by this pipe simply when we open the tap? No, we can't get any water until there is a force from behind or there is a pressure. To create this pressure, the water pipe should be connected to a water tank. As there is plenty of water in the tank, there will be more pressure in the mouth of the pipe. And as soon as we open the tap, if the pressure is low, the water starts flowing from the area having high pressure to the area having low pressure. Here too, like the slope, difference in pressure is obtained due to difference in height. So, we can conclude that to let the water flow, we need a pressure difference. If the water pipe is replaced by a metallic wire and a water tank is replaced by a battery, then we get something like this. We know that the circuit must be closed for the current to flow. Let's attach the other terminal of the battery to the bulb. Electricity is also like this tank's example. To let the electric current flow, we need a difference in the circuit, like there was a pressure difference in the analogy of water tank example. This difference in the circuit is known as potential difference. Just as the water flow from high pressure to low pressure area, similarly electric current also moves from high potential area to low potential area. The difference of voltage between one terminal of the battery and the other terminal is called potential difference. We get a potential difference due to various chemical reactions of the battery. In science, the work done in moving a unit charge from one place to another in the circuit is called potential difference. The difference is represented by the symbol of V and its SI unit is volt. A volt is the ratio of a joule and a coulomb. The potential difference is measured with the help of a device called a voltmeter. The voltmeter is always placed in parallel or parallel order. Various kinds of batteries having variation in potential difference are available in the market. In the upcoming videos, we'll get to know about the rules related to potential difference.